everyone, this is the fourth lesson of chapter 1, Powers of Monomials. In this lesson, you will apply law of exponents to find powers of monomials. In the previous lessons, you've learned how to use a power using a base with the exponent. On this lesson, what they're going to show you is if you have this power, but of this, you'll have another exponent. In order to find the power of a power, you'll be multiplying the exponents. And here's the reason behind. Let's say you have 6 to the 4th power, but of this, you have 5th power. Knowing that if you have the 5 as the exponent, that makes the whole term inside of the parentheses, this will be your base. So what you have now is you have the base, which is inside of the parentheses. You have this 5 times in multiplication. And if I fill this out with 6 to the 4th power, what you'd end up is that you learned in last lesson that when you are multiplying with the same base, you're just adding the exponent. Because you have 6 4 times in here, and then you have another 6 4 times. Here's a third one, and then the fourth one, and then the last one you will have 6 to the 4th power 5 times. And when you count them total, instead of we evaluate, let me just write using the exponent. So you have base as 6, but of this you have 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4. You have 4 5 times, so that's going to be 20. That's why when you're having a number or a variable inside of the parentheses with the exponent, if you have this to the other exponent, that's equivalent to when you have the same base with the power of 2 times 3. So if you have 2 3 times, that's going to be equal to 6. That's where this symbol came from. If you have a to the m's power of this, you have nth power, that's equivalent to you keep your base, but you're just multiplying the exponents. Let's look into some examples. Simplify using the law of exponents. So as you see, they're asking you to simplify, not to evaluate. So we will not use a calculator on this section, where if I'm looking at this, you have a to the 4th power of this, you have 3 times. So right now, your base is a to the 4th power and your exponent is 3. So in here, if you have parentheses, 3 times, using the exponent was 3. If I put your base, a to the 4th power. If you do not remember the law of exponents, you can simply expand this, such as you can write 8 4 times and you just repeat this 3 times, which will take longer than you expected. So that's why the law of exponents will make your life a little bit easier. If you just count all of them, you will have 8 to the 12th times when you count them. Or if you didn't want to do any of these steps, you could simply using the law of exponents saying when you have power of the power, you multiply 4 with 3. So when I did 8 to the 4th power times 3, this will become 8 to the 12th power. And you'd realize I get the same answer. So that's how I know this will be my final answer. Number 2, for the same reason, even though you have a variable, it should be the same steps. So in here, since you have a base k to the 7th power, but of this, you have 5 times. So then if I just multiply this, you will get k to the 35th power, and that's how I know this will be my final answer. One more time, if you want to expand it, you can do it on your own. You just write k 7 times, and you repeat this 5 times, and you just count them all, which will take a lot longer time than when you're just using law of exponents. Let's see if we can solve the next 3 questions a little bit quicker. So in here, since you have power of the power, if you keep the base, which is 2, you have 5 2 times. So 5 times 2, I should get 10, and that's going to be my final answer. For the next one, since your base is W, keep that. Where you have 4 6 times, that will give you 24, and that's going to be my final answer. The last one, I don't know if you have seen the brackets before, but this is very similar to your parentheses where it's just talking about the orders that you have to do. We are always going to do the parentheses first, but in here, do you see you have a base of that, you have exponent, but of that you have another exponent. So in here, overall, what you're doing is keep the base, that's what you did. You have 2 of this 3 times, but what they're saying is of this, you have 2 more times. So that's what this last number is. In here, if I simplify this, you'll get 3 to the 6th power. And of this, you have 2nd power, which is a similar over here. So 6 times 2, I'll get 12. In simpler way to explain, you were just keeping the base and multiply every exponent. So 2 times 3 times 2, I will still get 12. Now, what would happen if you have to find the power of a product? In order to find the power of the product, you will be still multiplying. So for example, instead of having just one number, you have a term in product. So what they're saying is the 5 is your exponent where you have the whole parentheses as your base. Repeating the same step as what I just did earlier, I'm going to copy down parentheses. So in here, I have parentheses 5 times. And if I fill it in with the base, it's 3a squared. This is where many people get confused because you have a number in front. When you have a coefficient, which is a number in front of the variable, do you see that you're multiplying in between the parentheses? And you're going to follow the same step. So 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 is what you're going to do. In other words, I will have 3, 5 times total because you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For the next one, when you have a, you see you have twice over here, another twice, and so on. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. This is how you're going to finalize the answer. And as you see, many people will make a mistake as they do remember multiplying the exponent, but they only do it to the variable over here. So their answer becomes like 3a to the 10th power, which is not as same as this one. So let's see if you need more practice. But when you write in symbol, if you had a times b of this to the nth power, when you write it, you will be writing a to the nth power times b to the nth power. You have to do it on all of them. It's like when you are learning the distribution. Here's an example 3. Simplify using the law of exponents. So again, if you have a parenthesis of this, you have 4 times. Let me write that down. 2. And then let's fill it out the base. The base is 4p cubed. So numbers, you can still calculate because it's a multiplication. So 4 times 4 times 4 times 4, you can evaluate. Or at this time, let's just write it as 4 to the 4th power and then we'll do the next step. The next one, the P has, you have 3, 3, 3, 3. So the total of 12 since you have 3 times 4. Some of the textbook would ask you to simplify the number because if you can simplify in math, you're supposed to calculate them. So let me write on the side note, if you had 4 times 4, that's 16. So 16 times 4, that's 64. And one more, 64 times another 4, that's equal to 256. So in here, my number will be 256. And P, there's nothing you can do. So that's why P to the 12th power is simplified number. Here's number 4, same thing. You have a parenthesis of this 5 times. Now let's see if I can actually just skip expanding steps. In here, remember how I told you that you're going to distribute? When you're looking at this term, there is a coefficient of negative 2. When there is no number on the exponent, we talked about it as there is 1 hidden. Because there's only 1 negative 2. So in here, if you distribute like this 3 times of each term, then you will get negative 2 5th time times m to the 7 times 5, I will get 35 times n to the 6 times 5, I will get 30. In here, if you have negative 2 5 times, keep in mind you're multiplying negative 5 times, it will become negative, so the sign doesn't change, and 2 to the 5th power. Same thing, let me write on the side. 2 times 2 is 4. Times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, times 2 I'll get 32, and then you just copy the rest. Then I have m to the 35th power, n to the 30th power, and that's going to be my answer. Just be careful when you're dealing with the negative. Here's the next number. Again, let's see if we can simplify, but this time let's do it a little bit quicker. So if you have 8, remember there is 1 hidden, so you have 2 a, which is a to the 2nd power, and b to the, if you have 9 already, but of this you have 2 times, so 9 times 2, I'll get 18. You have to simplify a square, which I will get 64, b to the 18th power, and that's going to be my answer. Part e, you have 6 to the 4th power, x to d, 5 times 4, I'll get 20, y to d, 44. You can pause in here for a second, see if you understand where this 4 came from. If you don't, please go back to the previous slide where I was just explaining why you have 5 instead of 1 like this. On the side note, 6 times 6 is 36. 36 times 6, I should get 216. And 216 times 6, that's the last one, I'll get 1,296. I was just using a calculator, so if you're struggling with multiplying like this, feel free to use a calculator because that's not our focus right now. So in here, I will have 1,296, x to the 20th power, y to the 44th power, and that's going to be my answer. The last one, remember that I told you to put the parentheses whenever you're dealing with a negative or fraction. So based on the last lesson, if I use that concept, you will have negative 5. Of this, you have 3 times total. And then you have w to the 2 times 3, I will get 6. Z to the 8 times 3, I will get 24. Remember I told you to be careful with the negative? Let's write on the side. Negative 5 times negative 5. Double negatives will become positive. So all I get is just positive 25. Where you have to multiply one more time. 25 times negative 5. Do you see how I only have one negative? So you have to have negative. Where when you multiply this, you will get 125. So my answer on here is equal to negative 125. W to the 6th power, Z to the 24th power. That's going to be my answer. The last problem of this lesson. A magazine offers a special service to its subscribers. If they scan the square logo shown on the smartphone, they can receive special offer from the magazine. Find the area of the logo. In here, they're telling you this QR code has a length of 7. I don't know if you can see it well, so let me write it down. 7. A to the 4th power times B. And since this is a square, if I know one length, I should also know this length right here, where it should be the same as over here. In order to find the area, and knowing that it's a square, you are multiplying length times length, but in here, let me just write it as a square, because you're multiplying the same thing twice. If I need a length, it's 7A to the 4th power times B. Of this, if you have square, you will get 7 squared, which is 49. A to the 4th power of this, you have square. So A, 8th power, since I'm multiplying them. And remember, B has to have 1 right here. So when you distribute, when you multiply this 2, it will become 2. And since they're not using any units in here, I'm okay with just the number. And this is going to be your final answer. Today's lesson is very short, and this is the end of the lesson. Thanks for learning with me. I'll see you next time.